सहना ववतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सहवीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। हरि ओम। भगवद गीता 18th चैप्टर 50th वर्स। सिद्धिं प्राप्तो यथा ब्रह्म तथाप्नोति निबोध में समासे नैव कौन्तेय निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य यापरा। कौन्तेय ओ सन ऑफ कुंती, सिद्धिं परफेक्शन प्राप्तः रीचिंग यथा हाउ ब्रह्म ब्रह्मन आप्नोति वन अटेन्स तथा दैट समासेन इन ब्रीफ मे फ्रॉम मी निबोधः लर्न ज्ञानस्य ऑफ नॉलेज या विच परा सुप्रीम निष्ठा कॉन्समेशन। सो लर्न फ्रॉम मी इन ब्रीफ ओ सन ऑफ कुंती हाउ रीचिंग सच परफेक्शन वन अटेन्स टू ब्रह्मन दैट सुप्रीम कॉन्समेशन ऑफ नॉलेज। So, Shri Krishna now wants to tell Arjuna how a person attains Brahman after having attained the Siddhi or perfection which he talked of in the previous verse. That is Naishkarmya Siddhi. That is the perfection where one becomes free from actions and the fruits of actions. Naishkarmya Siddhi. And that supreme consummation of knowledge. Jnanasya para nishtha. Supreme nishtha, consummation, fulfillment of knowledge. How is that attained? Now Shri Krishna will tell summarily. Earlier also many times in the Gita, Shri Krishna has used this phrase that I will summarily or briefly tell you things. What does it mean? Why is Shri Krishna repeatedly saying that I am going to tell you in brief? The idea is that Shri Krishna or a teacher, guru, the guru can only give you some guidelines. But one has to do it for oneself. One has to do it for oneself. So the student has to do it for oneself. And only if the student does it oneself, then that person can attain the truth which has been spoken of in the scriptures and by the Guru. So here, the state where one attains Brahman, that no matter what Shri Krishna says, Shri Krishna, God Himself says, it is not going to help Arjuna unless Arjuna is going to practice that. Unless Arjuna practices it, it is not going to help him. So that is why in brief. Why in brief? Because the details have to be worked out. The details have to be worked out by whom? The details have to be worked out by the sadhaka, by the spiritual aspirant. In the 51st verse, Shri Krishna says, बुद्ध्या विशुद्धया युक्तो धृत्यात्मानं नियम्य च शब्दादीन विषयांस त्यक्त्वा रागद्वेषौ विदस्य च। विशुद्धया प्योर, बुद्धया विद एन इंटेलेक्ट, युक्तः एंड्यूड, धृत्या विद फॉर्टिट्यूड, आत्मानं द बॉडी एंड द सेंसेस, नियम्य सबडूइंग च एंड शब्दादीन साउंड एंड other things, vishayan, sense objects, tyatva, relinquishing, raga dveshav, attraction and hatred, cha, and vyudasya, abandoning. So endued with a pure intellect, vishuddhaya buddhya, Vishuddhaya buddhya, endued having a pure intellect. Pure intellect, and then what does a person do? Controlling the body and the senses. Senses, and also how to control? Dhritya. Controlling the body and the senses with perseverance, with lot of patience. How does a person become free from impurity of the intellect? The idea is, one is free from intellect which is impure, or one has a pure intellect. That means one is free from doubt and misconception, and one is merged in Brahman. One is free from doubt and misconception. One is merged in Brahman. Merged in Brahman. By eliminating all the alien or all the attributes which are ascribed to the intellect, which are not its true nature. Ascribed to the intellect, which are not its true nature. So, by doing that, one becomes a person with a pure intellect. And also one has to control niyamya, control or subdue one's body and the sense organs. And then one has to relinquish tyaktva. After relinquishing, that is, one has to give up sense objects. What are the sense objects? Sense objects are sound, touch, smell, taste, vision. These are the sense objects. So all these sense objects have to be given up, and also one has to give up attraction and aversion. This 51st verse has to be read in continuation with 52nd and the 53rd verse. They are in continuation. So how do you give up sense objects? You give up sense objects by not having any extra craving for those sense objects. You have only those cravings, or you have only those sense objects which are necessary for the bare maintenance of the body. And all other things you give up. So you don't have any other craving or any other attachment or inclination to other kinds of sense objects, or sense objects which are more than what are necessary. You don't have any inclination. So if you eat food only for the sake of sustaining the body, not for the sake of taste. If you see something, you see that only for the sake of, again, sustaining the body, not for the sake of pleasure. So one should not indulge in the contact with the sense objects for the sake of pleasure. One should just follow the sense objects, or not follow, one should just use the sense objects for the sake of maintenance of the body. And so then what happens? A person becomes gradually away from the sense objects. Vivikta sevi lagvashi yata vakaya manasah dhyana yoga paro nityam vairagyam samupashritah. Vivikta sevi lagvashi. Vivikta sevi. Vivikta means separate. So going to a separate spot. Lagu ashi means eating little. Yata vakaya manasah, and controlling the body. Vak, kaya, vak is speech, kaya, body, and manasah, mind. Nityam, ever, ध्याना योग पर है एंगेज इन मेडिटेशन एंड कॉन्सेंट्रेशन. वैराग्यम डिस्पैशन समुपाश्रित है पोजेस्ड ऑफ. सो अ पर्सन रिटायर्स और गोज टू अ सेक्लूडेड प्लेस ईट्स अ लिटिल एंड दैट पर्सन्स बॉडी माइंड एंड स्पीच आर कंट्रोल्ड. And that person is engaged in meditation and concentration. And that person is possessed of dispassion. That person is possessed of dispassion. So that possessed of dispassion, engaged in meditation and concentration. And eating a little. Why eating a little? Because if you eat more, you will be sleepy, you will be lethargic, and eating more could also cause indigestion, problems with your stomach, which will make your mind restless. So eating little, which is necessary for the sustenance of the body, and meditation upon the self, meditating upon one's own true self, and dhyana yoga. So meditation and concentration. Concentration is one-pointedness of thought, so on one feature of the self, and dispassion for the seen and the unseen. So one has to go to a secluded spot, eat very little, and the body, speech and mind should be controlled, and one should be ever engaged in meditation and concentration, and one should be possessed of dispassion. So one should be having one-pointedness of thought and then meditate. So meditation, one-pointedness of thought, and concentration. And that person should have dispassion for the seen and the unseen. Dispassion for the seen and the unseen. The person should not get attached to the seen and the unseen. Ahankaram balam darpam kamam krodham parigraham vimuchya nirmamah shantah brahma bhuyaya kalpate. अहंकारं बलं दर्पं कामं क्रोधं परिग्रहं विमुच्य निर्ममः शांतः ब्रह्म भूयाय कल्पते. सो हैविंग गॉन टू अ सेक्लूडेड स्पॉट एंड कंट्रोलिंग वन्स बॉडी एंड द माइंड एंड ईटिंग वेरी लेस एंड performing meditation and concentration, one should possess of dispassion and having one's mind controlled, then one should ahankaram egoism, balam power, darpam pride, kamam lust, krodham anger, parigraham property, vimuchya giving up, nirmamah freed from the notion of mine, shantah tranquil, brahma bhuyaya for becoming brahman, kalpate one is fit. So one, after one's going away from the crowd, so to say, and controlling the mind and keeping quiet, and dhyana yoga parah, resorting to a regimen of meditation and concentration, and having vairagyam, dispassion, that person will become what? Will give up egoism, power, pride, lust, anger and property, And after having free, becoming freed from the notion of I, nirmamaha, mamaha, mine, that is having the idea that one possesses something, one becomes free from that idea and becomes peaceful, tranquil. And then that person is fit for becoming Brahman. Brahma bhuyaya bhuyaya kalpate. Brahma bhuyaya kalpate. So bhuyaya for becoming Brahman. Brahma bhuyaya kalpate. One person becomes fit. How does one become fit? By going, first having this pure intellect, then controlling the body and the senses with lot of fortitude or perseverance, and giving up sense objects and abandoning aversion and attraction, then a person goes to a secluded spot and that person engages in meditation and concentration. So though a person gives up all these sense organs or sense gives up attachment or controls one's mind and the sense organs, that person needs something to sustain one's body and to perform one's daily duties. And finally, that also is given up. Parigraha, property. So that is what is meant by property here. That also is given up. That basic minimum which is necessary to perform one's duties, that is also given up by this person, because that person does not consider one to be body or the mind. So that is the way. So you have to be vivikta sevi, laghu ashi, and yata vak kaya manasaha. And then dhyana yoga paraha. So one has to first go to a secluded spot and eat little and control the body and the mind. Sri Ramakrishna, in the Gospel of Sri Ramakrishna, was asked what is the duty of the householder? Being a householder, how to realize God? And so Sri Ramakrishna says, you have to do this. You have to go to a secluded place and stay for some time. And then you have to have the company of holy people. And then you have to do viveka or vichara. That is, you have to do discernment and prayer. By doing all of these, a householder or any person for that matter can attain to the highest goal, that is God realization. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi Hari Om Tat Sat Shri Ramakrishna Arpanamastu.